sa akin ganyan. Oh. Turtle, di ba? Parang ganyan, di ba? Okay, Ton. We're checking out. Thank you, Ton. Thanks, babe.
Until this afternoon, then.
Thank you.
What is the schedule? How long?
Concerned about the environment. Even if our sea lions want to do their part to help and protect the ocean, which of course is their natural home. So we form the Sea Lion Marine Patrol. Now we are the proud,
the brave,
the beautiful. Sir? Okay. Attention! Okay, to work in the field, our sea lions must be strong and physically fit.
Well, that's not a problem for Kai and Sophie, because they are both South American sea lions and not a seal. But how can we tell? Well, first, they have these big and powerful front flippers. But how powerful are they?
Sophie can show you. Drum roll, please.
Wow!
Officer, look. Now, officer, how is that for strength?
Not bad.
Hmm? What do you mean not bad?
Because Kai can do better than that.
Really? We would love to see that.
Okay, Kai? Are you ready? Another drum roll, please.
So she liked that. She liked it.
Well, this... Now, Kai here would like to demonstrate a very special skill that every member of the Marine Patrol must have, and that is their remarkable self-control. Now, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask Kai to lie down here on the deck, just like that, and I am going to place... four very juicy fish right in front of Kai's face. Now the rule is, he can only eat this fish on the clap of my hands and for only one at a time. Now, let's start with the first fish. Good boy. Now, second fish. That's good.
Okay.
Hey, what are you doing? Do you think you can fool Kai? Well, you can't unless everyone wants to try. Come on, clap your hands. Louder. Come on. Well, see that? I told you, he won't eat it unless I clap my hands. Kai, you can now have your third fish. See that? Now, one more fish to go, and we're done. Last fish. Did he eat the last fish? Yes? Come here, Kai. Now tell me honestly, did you eat the last fish? Come on, show them what happens to a bad sea lion. I don't know. Well, of course, I am only kidding. We never hurt our animals here at Ocean Adventure. In fact, I am going to give Kai another chance. But this time, it's gonna be more difficult. Because instead on the floor, I am going to place this very juicy fish right on top of Kai's big nose. Where he can see it, he can smell it, but he cannot eat it unless I clap my hands. Folks, same rule applies. Come on, fool Kai. What happened, Kai? Can we try that one more time? Okay, Kai, self-control. Remember. One more! Clap your hands! Louder! Now, see that? Now, Kai, you can have your fish. And that is so strong! Now, moving on. Okay, now it's shooting time! Yes. Officer, can we have any option? Now, Raymond, come here. It's your choice. You want to swim or lie down and roll over? Okay, lie down and roll over. The floor is wet and it's all yours. Come on.
Come on, let's finish. Grab your chest.
Grab your chest.
Close your feet. Oh. And wait for her. Good girl. come on. Wait. Good girl, Sophie. Okay, now, sir.
Think about it. We humans share this earth with nearly 9 billion species of mammals, reptiles, birds, insects, invertebrates, and other creatures. Now, we are surrounded with life. Right here in the Philippines, we have some really cool animals that you will be meeting today. Now, they all came from the Wildlife Defense Rescue Center, and we're going to explore their amazing and mysterious world. First, I'd like to introduce you to someone who really knows how to survive in this natural world. Now, the forest is home to the Isis, a people who live in harmony with nature. And read the bottom letters. Ready? Go!
S-T-A-S-O-R-T-B!
Wow! Amazing! Let's keep talking out! But anyway, you know, we're just kidding. We just wanted to emphasize that owls really do have amazing eyesight. Alright, well, ladies and gentlemen, I'll get a big round of applause for Bamboo and Bamboo. There they go. Alright, now this time, the next animal. Alright, now listen up, everyone. The next animal that I want to introduce to you is actually one of my favorite. And maraming natatakot sa kanya for no good reason. I don't know why. She has some very unique features, right? So for example, look at her tongue. See her tongue? See that? She can dance on it. Just like that. As for his reward, he'll have some of his favorite fruits like bananas and mangoes. Great job, Luna. Nice having you there. The turtles have a lot to say. They chuckle when happy and they're happy. So they will howl, grunt, and hiss. Hey Luna, where are you going? Hey, you wanna go back there?
Why don't we?
Are you gonna try again? Well, come on, are you?
Maybe I'm scared.
Yeah, that's nice, Luna. That's good. And you know what? They also use the butterfly smell to mark their territories. Great job. That's good. And right here in the Philippines, the turtles are only found in Palawan. You know what? They also have unusual hind feet that they can move down the tree head first, and that makes travel easy. Great job, Luna. Wow, amazing, right? I think that's the best of the long. So let's go big, really big. Check this girl out. Oh, that's a white belly sea eagle. She weighs 2.5 kilograms. Now, she may be big, it's on the side, but she does. She sneaks over the water surface and catches her prey with a smart palate. Well, seagulls are quite vocal. They talk a lot and it sounds like this. See that? Hear that? Well, it sounds more like a goose than an eagle, right? But you know, she may not be a talented singer, but she does have a pretty face and is graceful and wise. So once again, Jerry, can you show us how? Well, come on, go back to the trainer now. Alright, there she goes. Alright, get closer. Oh, you want to stay here? I think this may be the best time for everyone to take primers out and take pictures of Cherry. Wow, majestic, right? So everybody have a round of applause for Cherry and Trainer Rick. Alright, so thank you so much, Cherry. See that? Really big, right? Very majestic. See you later, Cherry! Now, In a travel through this wild world, we've met so many amazing animals, like Sharon. But unfortunately, some people see wild animals like those. They want to take them home and turn them into pets. But wild animals do not make good pets. Sadly, most of these animals, they suffer and die in the care of humans. So please, do not keep a wild animal as a pet. Instead, why don't we choose a domestic animal like a man's best friend? And this is Gigi. The dogs are intelligent, loyal, forgiving, and always glad to see you. Can you say hi?
It's para si Hachi. Para si Hachi.
You ready? Come on, hi. Okay, you know, you guys so much fun together, just like this.
Oh.
Their promise.